Heather, you're working with Physicians for Peace. You want mobility supplies. Can people actually donate their old prosthetics and it'll work elsewhere?
Well, we started this program, Larry, in 94 after I'd lost my leg. I was working in the war in the former Yugoslavia, and we had to find a really quick way of getting limbs to the amputees there. And we fitted up over 27,000 people with the same system. And then in the Indian earthquake in Gujarat, when we set up the tents, we worked with the Lions Club charity there. So I always like to not reinvent the wheel and find out exactly which agencies, which clinicians have been working on the ground in the countries rather than just go in and bombard and reinvent what people are doing. So Physicians for Peace have been on the ground for several years. They had a great clinic for rehabilitation and prosthetic care, and now it's been destroyed. So what I'm trying to do is appeal to people to go to all the hangar clinics, and most amputees will know what that means, and contact Physicians for Peace and take back any limbs that they're not using. We can reuse the components. I used to get the prisoners in England to take them apart, put them into compartmental boxes. And most importantly at the moment are crutches, to give someone the freedom and ability and to take the pressure off the carers around them, is to actually get around, start getting mobile before atrophy sets in.
How do you know where to send them? I mean, what do you do with the limb? If you're watching now and you want to donate, where do you send it?
You should contact physiciansforpeace.org. That's physiciansforpeace.org. And you can take it back to your local clinic that you got it from in the first place and ask them to help locate the local hangar company who have offered to collect them all, store them for us. And what I'd like to do is get as many crutches as possible first, because while there's infection, we can't fit limbs. I've collected a number of pomade, which is a temporary sponge blow-up leg, because the sooner you can create circulation in the early days of healing, the sooner it will start to work and minimize infection.
Sanjay, is the healthcare infrastructure in Haiti ready to handle an influx like this? Say, reaction to this program tonight, can they handle hundreds of crutches and wheelchairs and prosthetic limbs coming in at once?
Well, you know, it's a good question. They're certainly going to need that. Whether now exactly is the right time, I think, as Heather probably knows, having done this sort of work, they're still sort of in the acute phase of things. I mean, you know, amputations are still being performed, Larry. It takes some time after an amputation is performed. The wound has to heal. The swelling has to go down. Eventually the prosthetic gets fit, but that can be a few weeks from now still. And I think that, you know, there's several different organizations which have been performing these amputations. I mean, there have been so many of them, Larry, that we're standing outside a Swiss tent right now, but the Partners in Health organization, Mount Sinai, which is a hospital in New York that you're familiar with, Larry, there's so many different organizations doing this. So I think it's going to be a little bit of time before we're in that phase, but it's coming, no doubt.
Heather, I know you did this historically on our show once. I would appreciate if you did it again. Would you show us your limb so that people around the world can get an idea of how they'll be helping?
Right, this now, is actually the kind of limb that we need to find to donate. But like Sanjay said, I'm fully aware that they're not going to need the limbs for weeks. But it takes weeks to coordinate. It takes weeks for people to donate. It takes weeks to get them packed and shipped, as you saw when disasters happen, before they got food, before they got things. So it's thinking three or four steps ahead. And it will be very soon that they will need crutches, most importantly. No. So this is an artificial leg, typical. And this is a socket on my leg, which has a screw attachment. And what we do is you have an attachment in here, and then the leg just goes on and pops in, and it actually screws in. So that's the attachment that we need to have to make it very simple for people to be able to get about so it doesn't get hot. But we need to collect as many as possible, because it takes us weeks to actually take this limb apart and find the components and put them into boxes. And what we don't want is, when they are able and ready to have a limb fitted, that we're still messing about and struggling to do this. Yeah. This is why I work with companies that are already doing it down there. So you're not just going in, you know, blindfolded. You're working with people that have been there for several years, as Physicians for Peace have.